student, and now I am going to show you another experiment of organic laboratory, that is experiment number 2, and that one is what? Identification of liquid, known or unknown organic sample. So I am going to perform today ethanol sample. So this one is a known sample. So what do we have to do? We have to follow the flow chart, which is for liquid sample. So according to the flow chart, what is the first test? Miscibility in water. So for that, what do you have to do? We have to take a test tube. So actually we have to check whether ethanol is miscible or immiscible in water. So for that, in a test tube I am going to take some drops of the sample, and here we have to add some distilled water. So you can see no layers are present over here, no separated layer presents over here. All the sample is miscible in distilled water. Okay, so we can consider this one is our sample ethanol is miscible in water. Now what we have to do according to flowchart? Lead mass test. Okay, as it is miscible, so that is why you have to come this side and we have to perform the lead mass test. So for lead mass test, what you have to do? We have to take a litmus paper, blue litmus paper, and this we can directly put inside the sample container. So no changes. Okay, that means what? You can say this is a neutral solution. So neutrals means what? We have to follow this path, and coming test is what? Whether our sample is light or viscous. Okay, so how can we check whether it's light or viscous? See, I think this is light, because what? It quickly flow, it not takes time to flow. Okay, if it is viscous, then it's not quickly flow like this. Okay, viscous means if you saw the cup syrup, you can say that cup syrup is a viscous thing, but this is not a viscous. Okay, so now coming test is, so you can consider this one is light and coming test is iodoform test in NaOH. Okay, so for iodoform test, what you have to do? We have to take a test tube, we have to take some sample, and there we have to add some water. Then there, what you have to add? We have to add a strong base, that is sodium hydroxide. Okay, we have to perform iodoform test in NaOH. So this is the NaOH, sodium hydroxide. I'm going to add this one inside the test tube. Now what we have to do? We have to add Ki, iodine solution, iodine in Ki into the test tube. Okay, so I am going to add some drop first of all. So you can see the transparentness of the initial solution is changes into the faint yellow color. Okay, and I think it's consumed little bit more iodine solution. You can see it's changed into faint yellow color. Something is present inside. Okay. Now what we have to do? We have to heat this one in the hot water bath very carefully, because for iodoform test, if you overheat this one, the coming precipitate should be dissolved. So above 60 degree, if your temperature source is above 60 degree, that can dissolve the coming precipitate. So carefully you have to handle. Okay, so I'm going to put this one over here for just a while. Precipitation is formed inside the test tube, but it takes some time to settle the precipitate. Okay, so you can consider this one is as a positive iodoform test. Okay, so I just keep this one inside the test tube rack, test tube stand, let it be settled, and then I will show you again this one. So now, according to flow chart, coming test is what? So as it is positive, we got yellow precipitation, that means we have to follow this path. And now coming test is what? Again we have to perform iodoform test in NH4OH. Okay, NH4OH means a dilute base. Okay, instead of NaOH we have to use NH4OH. Okay, so again we have to perform the iodoform test. So we have to take some sample. Then you have to add some water. Now here you have to add some NH4OH, ammonium hydroxide. Okay. Now in this we have to add again iodine solution. So as we added iodine solution, it turns into this color, and this is not like the previous one. Actually positive observation is what? Faint yellow coloration with a PPT should be appear. So only the color changes and nothing is present inside the test tube, and you can consider this one as a negative observation. Okay, so you can see the difference. This one is the positive observation and this one is the negative. This one is for NaOH and this one is for NH4OH. Okay, and you can see something is settled down at the bottom of the test tube. Okay, let it be settled properly. I'll show you again. And so according to the flow chart, we got no yellow PPT, that means what? Ethyl alcohol. So this is our preliminary tests, and all the preliminary tests we completed. So now what you have to do, you have to perform the confirmatory test for the ethanol. So we are going to do the confirmatory test. Okay, now as we completed preliminary test, now we are going to perform the confirmatory test for the ethyl alcohol. So first confirmatory test is what? Oxidation test. Okay, so oxidation test means we have to oxidize the ethanol using copperware. Okay, so that for that what you have to do, you have to take some sample. And this one we have to keep inside the ice bath, the cold water, inside the cold water or inside the ice bath. And then after that we have to take a copper spiral or copper well like this, and this we have to put inside the flame, and once it red hot like this, we have to dip it inside the test tube. Okay, so for 1 ml sample we have to do this minimum 10 times. So I do this one nearly 10 to 12 times. So now what we have to do, our oxidized solution is prepared. Now with this oxidized solution you have to perform the tolerance test. For that you have to prepare a tolerance reagent. So I am going to prepare a tolerance reagent. So for that we have to take 1 ml silver nitrate. Then here we have to add some sodium hydroxide. And after adding sodium hydroxide, it gives a precipitation. And this one we have to dissolve using the NH4OH. Okay. So we add some drops. Always we have to add this one drop wise. This NH4OH in this mixture drop wise, because to avoid the adding of excess ammonia. Almost dissolved. I think it's consumed 1 to 2 drops more. Yeah, now you can see it gives us a transparent solution, clear solution. So this is the tolerance reagent, and this one we have to add in the oxidized solution. And this we have to put inside the hot water bath. Okay, so yeah, you can see a mirror is come inside the test tube, in the inner wall of the test tube. Okay, good silver mirror is come. So that means what? This one is positive. Okay, so now our first test is over. First confirmatory test is over. First test is what? Oxidation test, that is over. Now the coming test is what? Iodoform test. Okay, so as we did iodoform test in preliminary section, so no need to do the iodoform again. As I told, I will show you later. So now you can see the iodoform that I did in preliminary section. All the yellow PPT is deposited over here, and this one, this I perform in presence of strong base. Okay, presence of NaOH. So we got this like precipitation, and so no need to perform the iodoform again. And another one, we have to again repeat the iodoform test using NH4OH, that also I did in the preliminary section, and the observation of that is got like this. So both the tests we already completed in preliminary section, so no need to perform that one again. So that means what? Yeah, our identification of ethanol is completed. That means all the, as we completed all the confirmatory tests, that means the sample detection is also completed. So that's all. Thank you guys.